Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to RGN here for map number two of this best of three. Again, Epsilon versus Archangel, or Archangel, or whatever you'd like to call them. And at the moment, we do have Epsilon up a map. They were able to take Overpass in pretty convincing fashion. So we did have quite the lull in action in between maps. Quick's trying to get his situation sorted out. I don't know how much success he's found, but hopefully he sorted out. It seems to be some FPS dropping issues, so... Nonetheless, moving forward, we will see the T-side boosting three players up. And, well, Quicks is going to be the man with the bomb on his back. And Downey off towards the B-bomb site. So here we go. Execution underway. Oh, Zello. He is going to be playing from sandbags here, and he does fall. I thought he may have had an opportunity to stop this rush of sorts, but not going to be the case. Let's go Doppelin with one. But they safely make it into the bomb site, so worrisome spot here. Draken coming up from the flank. So I've got two on highway, one at truck, one from a main. We'll see how these fights pan out here. Disco Doppelin slowly creeping up from truck, trying to take the fight versus Quicks, but Quicks, nice shot from him on a Freddy. And they're going to follow it up on a res as well. So Disco Doppelin and Draken to try and bring it back. Now a 2-on-3. They did have a kit on one of their members, if I'm remembering. Yeah, okay, there is one at the toxic barrels here, but whether or not that's going to be communicated, I don't even think there's enough time. Draken, 1v2, he is going to have to retreat here. So, T-side pistol picked up by Archangel. Good news for them, as, again, that is a solid start on their map choice. Are you with me, Laser? Laser's not with me. Sad times, guys.
Sorry, I'm back.
Oh, yeah. We're back.
Oh, God, we're live?
Fist around. We're live.
Ha, good timing.
Yeah, up around here is Archangel. And they're going to move into a Glow AK buy. Only the MAC-10 on Quicks. So, Epsilon, they will not fully invest in this round. They've still got a little bit of money, so interesting that they decide to go without the extra utility, but keep it a little in the bank.
I have no idea what happened on pistol. Sorry, guys, a bit late. I do have the four spy coming up from Epsilon. Wow, the one versus one, won by Freddy B, right outside of B. And now he'll pick himself up an AK and still post on the position. Doesn't want to fall back to B, interestingly enough. Probably worried about the connector area. One of his teammates has gone down in the meantime. That was Rez only with the Deagle. But Freddy has to make some use of this AK, and he even has an incendiary for a potential A retake.
Goblin spots a player towards mid, but takes a shot, falls back. And we will see Quick slowly working up this highway area. The one-handed walk animation, something I'll never get over, as Quick slowly works his way up. Looks so bizarre as he heads up into this A-bomb site. And he's going to peek towards truck, break him there to take a fight, but he goes down. So two players inside of the bomb site. Difficult situation to come out on top. Disco Doppelin with one, but that will be the extent of his success. So Freddy, lots to get done here as he eats a smoke to the teeth. But, well, still able to find the initial frag and the follow-up. Downey is super low.
I love this reposition by Downey, though. He's going to go towards connector and then up on top of the railings. Freddy B, he has so much to clear, but he's never going to think about clearing on top of him. If he does, he's cheating, Chad. There's no way you expect this. Brilliant play by Downey. I'm getting hit by that 100% of the time. When you have to worry about everything, and then you clear connector, you're never thinking about Raptors. So slick.
Nice play there from Downey in the end. Ended up being a very expensive round, but it was a force buy for Epsilon, more or less. Again, they kept $800 here and there, $600, $400, but you can see, it will be a save moving into this round. Got a P250, CZ75, but that is about it. So, any creative play here from Epsilon? Not looking like it. Draken decides to go in the sandbags corner. I don't think that they will neglect to check this, considering on pistol round they had a player here on the CT side. So, after that kind of information comes out, feel like you're probably going to be checking that anytime you waltz on pass. But Zealous, maybe he can find something out of his boost towards A, but I'm not a big fan of this anti-eco setup, or this eco setup, rather.
Yeah, it's pretty stale. I guess they do have a totem pole and then a very minor crossfire. That totem pole just gets eaten alive by fetched, and that's the problem with this sort of eco. Yeah, on ecos in general, you're not expecting too many frags, or that's what you're hoping to get, but you're trying to maximize that opportunity, and usually that's done with sacks or aggression, something like that. So by playing standard, so I think that's the least chance of netting you any frags, but a lot of teams still seem to go with it on rounds where they don't have much. A MAC-10 gained by Freddy, but that's not a weapon you want to bring into the next round. So bad of a weapon, in fact, that he'll stick with his CZ, at least for the longer engagements. But I am wondering why Freddy isn't just Ramboing in. I suppose he's trying to save some money on the opposition. I guess he brings a CZ into the next round. Either way, I would have liked for him to just hunt for an AK or something.
I think that's what he was hoping for. He was hoping for someone to exit out A-Main or Squeaky, because it was an A-side plant, but, well, T-side gave him nothing. They all exited Highway and towards, well, the CT side of things. So he gets no targets, and yeah, he's got a MAC-10, so not a fun spot. He's actually, wow, okay. All right. Well, he's going to keep it, go with some utility, and we'll see how this works out. He's playing towards Checkered. Suppose that's a better spot for a close-range weapon like this, but flip over to the T side of things. We've got the crisscross smokes coming out through middle here, but heavy pressure towards Squeaky. You don't see this a lot. Three players exiting Squeaky. They're not checking towards A main, and that could have gone either way depending on the way that the T's checked. They just assumed that there would be a player towards site or quad, but wasn't quite the case as we go back and forth. Downy all alone, 1v3 towards Fork.
Kind of a bizarre strat there by Archangel to go three out Squeaky. Problem was their opponents were playing one on top Shroud, one bottom Shroud, after they just threw a deep smoke into A main, which halted the A main players, which killed the split entirely. So unless the entries were made out of Squeaky, and of course they didn't expect those players there, you're gonna have a bad time. And even if Epsilon did have both players inside of the bomb site, they still would have had a good chance to deal with them because only players were coming out of Squeaky. Usually you want to split simultaneously. There's definite power in that, but it was halted by Archangel.
We'll see how the follow-up round goes here, as we still have Freddy on that MAC-10. And unfortunately for him, there is still a full buy to deal with. So one more round where he's got to keep that, and then maybe in the next tier, a little eco, and he can make some money off of it. But the T's playing fairly slow here. Fetched off towards Sunroom. Couple off towards middle, watching for a counter boost. Nades get a sail on over. Doesn't do a heck of a lot other than kind of some dust shrapnel. Dust from the shrapnel onto the T's head. But Disco Doppelin for frag. He's in A main. Able to find quicks to follow it up after he takes down a player in A main, so one towards main, one towards Squeaky, and well, dusts off his hands, and he's got some support with him as well.
Shrapnel dust, no less, right? Chad. He pushes up into A main, and it seems to happen a lot. Like, when a player pushes into A main, if you're that Squeaky player lurking, you want to open up that door and trade off on your teammates so bad. Problem is that Forklift can create some problems, even if you know a player is there. He wasn't able to train off on Doppelin, and that creates an even worse situation for Archangel. And they get destroyed coming out of A main. That's two in a row for Epsilon, and an immediate economy, too.
Like in this Pepsilon thing that we've got going on in chat here.
Where'd that start?
I have no idea. But I like it. Pepsilon, something like that. They need to get that sponsor hooked up ASAP. Man, you can just see the Epsilon and Pepsi can swirling around each other, something like that. I don't know. Make it happen, Epsilon.
I want to figure out origin to memes. Like, there's got to be, like, if you could, it's impossible.
Right? I patent this meme. It came, it was created by me. I think that's the best part about memes, but. Well, we're going to see the T side attempting to bust into this B-bomb site, but damn. Nothing through the fire and the flames. Draken just sent them flying, packing as well with his AWP. I think one of those was a collateral. Nice shots from him.
Feels good when that happens. I'm just sitting in the back of the site. Peek, first guy down, re-peek, he's down. Your teammate provides you with a little assistance. You re-peek for the finisher, get the double. We're on to the next round. Even more of an economy. Three rounds, and it looks like Epsilon have won even more in a row. As Archangel will switch it up and go for the dedicated A play. The moment that Epsilon is doubling up towards the Squeaky, the timing of the play. Brilliant by Epsilon. One member does get traded out, and Disco decides to hang around in the Squeaky area. He should definitely get out of there, but he's worried that he might not make it out alive. Definite cause for alarm. And I'm surprised Epsilon didn't get out of there even more ahead.
Shifty play. Disco Doppelin, he picks up the op and throws his M4 over to Zelos, who had a P90. So, although they lose a player, they kind of upgrade accordingly. And Draken, yeah, missing pretty critical shot towards A main. If he lands that, like, that push works out incredibly. But unfortunately, he whiffed it pretty hard and fell because of it. So, 4-on-4. And we can see the vacation of this A bomb site. Interesting stuff. Disco Doppelin is still back towards the truck here. Zelos off towards highway. And we've got decent utility to hold us off. Zelos sending in an incendiary. Flash towards Fork as well. So causing some issues. They still have Freddy. Okay, Freddy's off on the other side of the map, so he's not going to be able to help out with his incendiary anytime soon. But Rez and Zelos finding frags. Doesn't look like it'll make a difference. Zendi in a 1v4. He's looking around. A smoke that has been deployed, but Rez has his number. So another round here for Epsilon as Pistol and the two thereafter. Good news for the T side, but they haven't picked up anything since.
Right, guns come out and Pepsilon frags out. Seems to be the story so far. Four rounds lost bonus and a bomb plant. Archangel gonna buy again. They went with the set A play. Problem is they were met with the aggression, but they did get the bomb down in a winnable situation. That's worrisome if you are rooting for Archangel. And it's notable that Freddy, the bomb site was already taken, and he did not budge until the bomb went down. And that's just a really diligent player. he played by the rule. Like, you don't rotate until bomb is called or spotted. One or the other, and he stayed true to that.
Right. This caller is telling him to rotate. He's like, no, you told me I don't rotate until I see the bomb. I am anchoring this B bomb site. He's like, all right, Freddy. All right, taking it literally. But anyhow, we got Disco Doppelin falling in A main. Got aggressive there. So not a good start to the round as the T's already with a bomb plant. So immediate rotation, obviously. Draken does find one here. Creates a 4-on-4.
And usually there'll still be a smoke up there allowing that player to get back into Squeaky. But Highway has been open this entire time. Weird spam coming out from Draken. But the utility advantage is immense here for Epsilon. Twitch does have an incendiary to try to battle back with. But it's all Archangel here on the retake. Denying Epsilon access from the Highway. And I think we're going to see a save. Even though Epsilon have a massive economic lead, it still could be kept by keeping a couple weapons in play and not losing everything. And I don't think there's quite enough to hunt with if you are Archangel, but they're going to go for it anyway with a boost. They need each other. Freddy boost. 4-4.
Right. Freddy boost indeed. That was great. Both teams, same idea. Let's boost over and see if we can find something over middle here. And Freddy comes out on top. So that will be that as we move forward. 4-4. So first rifle round pickup for the T side. See if they can follow it up. That is a bit of a requirement. CT still have quite the bank behind them. He's got 5k on two members, 3200 on Rez, 11k on Freddy. He is the bankroll at the moment. And Archangels off towards B here. Heavy play as well. Rez, he's getting aggressive up on top of these boxes. And he might just find a lot of success here. It really depends how this pans out. Flash comes in. It's not going to be effective to Rez at all. He grabs
nice.
Him before going down. Freddy will fall, but 3-on-3.
Nice by Rez. Not so much by Freddy, though. Can the bomb get in there safely? I think he just made it around the op of Draken. The incendiary going down, though. Is he going to have to trade his life? Ooh, down to 17 HP. Did get out of there alive. And a retake is on, but Zelos has to make his way around from the Sunshine area where a player is lurking. How did Quick fail that? Oh, gotta blame the mouse on that one. Guess he's still having some problems because there's no way you lose that duel. You shouldn't be able to. It wasn't even a headshot from Zelos that brought him down. Just highlighting the amount of time, but Zendi could still do this way out on top of the rafters as Draken, but the defuse is on. And not a hard reset for Archangel, but almost.
Unfortunate situation for them, certainly, as pick up a round, lose the one they're after, and they've got 4,200, 5k, a little bit of money in the bank, but will be a save round here. see what they can get done in the next round. And as for the CT side, okay, Draken with that AWP. No SMGs. Of course, no one... actually, they did have people going down, obviously. Only two CTs survived that round, so... would have expected maybe some SMGs, or at least one. Not the case, though, as we see Draken pick up a frag onto Downy. So nice start here, and this is a very spread-out approach. Almost a... I don't like this at all from the T side. You're playing a bit of a default layout when you've got less than optimal weaponry. You've got beagles and such, and, well, they're all falling laser.
Yeah, I see a lot of teams do this, where you spread out and go with deegs only, and...
That's so awesome.
I missed it.
Oh, they opened up the squeaky door and went for the flash play in, but Fetch moves behind the door already. So he scouts the player in the back of the head as he peeks in and then finds a follow-up with the op. They still have a chance here, but Fetch, I think it would be a good idea to swap that op over to Dominate. What a funny situation.
I think Fetch is a better op of the two, so still the full HP might be the better option. There's already two players at the A bomb site. Wall of flank is on. Dominate, can he recover the op? He can, but trades his life for it. Six for Epsilon, and yeah, back to that type of round, and kind of surprising that two frags were allowed. When you go with Deegs like across the board and spread out, generally you have to have just crazy aim on everybody and confidence on everybody that they'll win some of those duels marginally. I just don't see that for Archangel. I forget what team before that did it with Rom and all them. Or maybe I'm thinking of somebody else. Anyways, another gun round out. 6-4. And we'll see the play by Archangel. Similar to the last B play, but time they want to split it.
They went for the crisscross smokes in middle, but they both threw the same smoke. It's the same spot. Zelos is now creeping through, and he's like, there's no one here, guys. Only goes down to Downy, so I suppose that's a silver lining in it all. And no one even took out middle, so we'll see how this B-team actually pans out. Freddy and Draken come up with frags, but right back at him. 2-on-2, Downy and Zindi. Look a little on the low end, still one in the bomb site, but Rez falls. It's now up to Disco Doppelin versus Downy.
I'm coming up on the flank here. If Downy goes into the CT, is he going to do it? Oh, he might just do it. He's going to go back to B, though. And now he's waiting for the flank to come out. Mind games, Chad. This is crazy. Both teams, or both players, just trying to outthink each other to the point of stagnation. They've just both just posted up.
They're both looking at me, just like, all right, eventually I will gather this frag. If I just wait long enough here.
It's a battle of patience.
Mind games intensifies as well, eventually, they might come in contact here. Downy still holding that angle. Disco Doppelin, they finally take the duel. And Disco Doppelin, able to dance his way to a victory there. Another round for Epsilon.
Oh my god, his knife is called the Disco Doppler. Disco Doppler, please.
Oh, that's so great. Oh, that is fantastic. I love Disco Doppelin so much. Never met the guy personally, never even talked to him, but I love him.
Right. Great guy. 10 out of 10. Take me. I wonder if there's any disco clubs still out there. Probably not of the the hetero variety.
Oh boy.
We got pistols out for Archangel. And last time they went with the spread out approach. That did not work at all. So this time they'll sell a one-man fake towards B. Doesn't cause anybody to rotate. Wait, it causes both players to rotate? Oh, it's because he got both kills. Downy just runs through the bomb site. Oh my god, this is crazy.
Downy just wrecks the B-bomb site, and well, Epsilon, they're kind of scratching their heads. They're like, well, we really thought it was that bomb site, but not the case at all. Rez is going to pick up an AWP and more than likely save it. Zelos is playing towards middle. They have no money really left in the bank here on that CT side, so Zelos is getting aggressive still. Rez is nowhere to be found. He's like, nah, 1v4, I got this, man. They don't got... I'm dead. It's all you, Rez. That was a little bit piece of their team comm there.
Yeah. I hope not.
I don't know what he was
bad
thinking.
Comms.
Rez was inside of B. Like,
in a 2v4, one man goes, one man doesn't. That's the thing. And if they would have saved, I mean, look at their money here. One guy's going to be left without. If both save, they have a full bot.
I don't understand that at all.
This is what I was talking about, Chad, right at the beginning. Like, on LAN versus online, like, some people have said that like Epsilon get a little comfortable and then start making some loose decisions. We saw some of it on Overpass by rushing through the smoke with knives, and then it almost lost them around. Now here, I mean, are they just feeling confident and loose? Like, do they feel like they have the match already won?
They're up 7-5. It's definitely comfortable at this point, but it could slip away. Specifically, if they lose this round, find themselves in eco territory, that would not be a fun spot. Could turn into an even an 8-7 if they keep letting these go. So big round underway. We'll see if Epsilon plays a little bit tighter this time around, as they still are able to get a decent buyout from Austin Zelos, but we'll have maybe a better weapon here as Dominate takes a lot of damage early off towards the vents, and he is caught in a very awkward spot here, but maybe they can utilize that, and indeed they do. Flash comes in towards Highway. Disco Doppelin was focused on vents, but he falls, and Zendi follows it up.
Coming back, Archangel. Zelos one back at him, but the Sunny play by... Where is it? Fetch. Okay, he finally will trade off onto Freddy B. Dominate, gotta be a little flustered. Like, how did you let a player push all the way through B when you're in Sunshine and kill me? It does make it a 2-on-3. Zelos and Rez in position to stop the bomb from arriving, and we do have the quad boost. What a funny 2-on-3 here, and now they lose the bomb. Epsilon already had intel that players were inside of the bomb site, but Zelos gonna lose the duel. Rez versus 2.
Yeah, Zelos really wanted... Oh, no. Rez is going to botch his nade and then dies to Zendi. What a... That was really not good at all. Zelos whiffed pretty hard. He was holding an angle onto the player that took the duel towards... And a crossing towards a main. He whiffs like crazy. And then, the follow-up whiff. The nade hits the corner. We've all been there. And he falls to a headshot thereafter. So, Archangel, they're finding... Some fortune here on top of their own success, and it's found them 6 rounds. So pistol round included, the 2 thereafter. So Epsilon has done a good job considering they didn't pick up pistol, but we'll see what they can get done. That's some proper
get
English
do.
Right there.
I heard some slang earlier, Chad. Now you're just taking it over the top. Zelos flanking though with the op, and he's gonna get 2. This match has just gone crazy. Just gone mad in the last couple of rounds. Like, the teams that shouldn't be winning clearly are.
This is ridiculous. Downey brings it back on a Disco Doppelin, but 2-on-4. We'll see if the T's can bring it back. What a round to drop those. We'll see. Rez takes down Dominate. Downey, 1v4. Bad shot there, and follows it up as well. So, needs to ace. That's the issue at the moment. Draken is moving through the mid-warehouse area, and they're playing in a way that they are giving Downey the chance to take some duels, and Draken does not have armor, so Aim Punch would come into the equation. Downey just playing it nice and slow.
Are they gambling that he's not going to go to A? Because if so, playing 1-1 without those two players at a bomb site is just silly in my eyes. Draken, I think he just missed the bomber moving up. Oh, he catches him making his way into Squeaky. Got to be a bit critical of the Epsilon setup there. The point of playing 1-1 is you'll have a player at each bomb site. The point of playing 2-1 or 2-0 is you'll have two players available for the trade. But by playing 1-1 without both players at a bomb site just doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah, they're just kind of roaming. They're mercenaries on the map hoping that they just find the last player, I suppose. But interesting stuff indeed. Epsilon taking a round that they really had no right taking, but they did. So we'll see if the T's can come back and at least find 7 in this half. Wouldn't be too bad at all. It's a fairly even map. Oh, and it honestly, it's even been leaning more to the T side recently. You could still make the argument that it's CT-sided, but I'm thinking fairly 50-50 as we see the T side heavy towards Squeaky. Downey and his teammate Quicks both working this real estate, so I'm wondering what's going to transpire here. We got Zendi waiting for the same main smoke. They've got a boost underway at the moment. Considering no one's watching B, I imagine we're going to see a quick play towards A here in just a moment.
This is one of the times where the A play is made where Epsilon actually have numbers at the A bomb site. Draken on to fetched at middle though, but that will not delay the split. Actually, the CT and A main, Zelos getting... very aggressive. Wow. He pushes and brings down both of them. Now the situation where Squeaky tries to trade off on the aggression can be difficult. Unless you're Downey. Gets 2. And the score settles at 9-6. A lot of the times when Archangel had taken into A, it was a setup for Epsilon where they play 1-1-3, or maybe, yeah. And they have that highway guy shift over, and when they do that, they have their A main player aggress. And it's just a weird tendency, because a lot of teams will play that player passively when they're playing a more mid and B-centric style. But 9-6, this is, I gotta say, in favor of Epsilon. I mean, recently we've seen whenever the preparation is there on both ends, it has been T-sided, and that's hard for a lot of people to swallow, but it's the truth.
So here we go, moving into the next half. I did see someone say in chat, I don't know why I didn't put this together already, but I believe it should be Fietz? Oh my god, I'm gonna butcher it. I was planning on trying it just to see if I'm gonna do it. It's a Y instead of a J, and that makes sense from where they're from. So, Fietz? Something like that. I probably butchered it, but anyhow, moving forward. I'm gonna attempt to do it. I'm gonna sound like a goose, so please.
If one of you guys want to teach me, I'm down.
They gave us the kind of the phonetic pronunciation inside of chat, but you might have to scroll up a little bit. Nonetheless, we'll try our best here. Don't want to be mispronouncing as we move into this A side play. We've got three on the bomb site already. Quix finds the first on Drew Rez, so good news there. As the bomb's going down.
Can be hard to hold off these USPs. You want to cut the numbers down before the retake is on, but then of course if you do peek, you're giving those USPs that range advantage. Three players left. You got to give it to Archangel, but pistol always a very volatile round. All rounds in Counter-Strike, and there it is. They line up for Draken and Disco. Zelos with one as well, but Dominate still has a chance. Doesn't have a lot of HP, so from the 3-on-5, instant. 3v2 as they get done in by the crossfire from Quad as well as the bomb site. Really nice timing of the peaks, though, from Quad in sight.
So Epsilon able to pick up their T-pistol, similar to how Archangels were able to do so as well. And you gotta think that that'll give them quite the advantage moving forward here. As soon as we see rifles, it's gonna be a bleak situation. Pretty much half the score line on that CT side. And if Epsilon makes it over that hurdle, again, could be a quick map number two here. Epsilon trying to 2-0 their way into our playoff bracket. And a win on this map would do exactly that. Fietz able to find the first frag here onto Zelos. Nice dig shot. And that will be a 4-on-4 as we continue.
Oh god, chat, now you got me wanting to pronounce it right.
It's Fietz? Hard. Fietz, exactly.
All right.
Kind of like Fiat, only it's like Fietz. I don't know. That's how I'm trying to make it work.
Swedish man in chat, let us know. Dominate, he was on the struggle before, but it looks like he's gotten himself more than just one. He's at three here, and he's inside of the checkers area. He does have a teammate at his back. That's his fourth. He needs to turn around, but now it's the headset comes up onto Freddy B, but no, they're both traded off right away. Still a 2-on-2, though. Not out of this quite yet for the CT side, and there it is. Quix comes up from the vents. Disco does want to go for the plant, never mind just a tap. He's waiting for the other player to arrive. But by not going for the plant now, he has allowed both CTs in the area. So that makes it much more difficult to get the plant down. Another fake. And no bite.
He's going to be going for another bait here. Now he will commit to it. And a player coming up quick. Quix, but the trade comes in. Zendi takes down Disco Doppelin as soon as he peeks out wide. So will be the CTs picking up the follow-up round. Good news, considering this round did not go their way. So we'll see if this is Archangel's map choice. They would love to be able to send this into a third one. We do have Inferno on the horizon if we require it.
Again, vomit.
Could be one of the last times we see it, so that's kind of what I keep telling myself. It's kind of one of those situations where it's like, I really don't want to see that map, but because it's one of the last times, it's like, all right, I should probably at least be somewhat happy about it. But anyhow, still not, as you can hear. But we'll see how that one goes if we make it that far. We will see a follow-up buy here for the T-side, trying to keep that momentum back in their court.
It's a weird buy. For Epsilon, it's one of those buys where is the goal just to keep your opponent's economy low? Because if the goal is to win, then you figure you get as much on the board as possible. I guess it can be a double approach. But into the bomb site, Freddy B entry, Freddy B two entries, Zendi and Quix. God, the Tech Nines. I mean, it's still super powerful.
Most definitely. So they find their way in 4-on-3. So we'll see 2 from truck here. And the scout on highway. First frag going the way of Rez. So Downey and Dominate. The double D's laser. They're going to try and get it done. But it looks like they might have to fall off. And it's going to be the case. So Epsilon. Back and forth we go. They force by. And they bring the momentum back their way. So a little bit of the silver lining considering we've got 2 weapons saved. But I imagine we'll see a force buy behind this next round for the CT side. Unless they just want to see what damage they can get done with these weapons. I'm uncertain.
Yeah, not sure either. True double D though. Disco Doppler. Atop the scoreboard of Epsilon. Just can't get enough of that name. And double save. Or buy on top of these 2 weapons. I gotta go with the latter. They're 13-7. If they don't force buy here, they're banking on winning from the 13-7 margin. And I think it's the right play to go for the force buy. This is a big round for Archangels and one of the harder ones to win. But Epsilon, don't go for the full buy in return. They do have enough to buy up upon losing, so I guess that's the math. But the aggression coming out. And my game crashed.
Fun times, indeed. As we see Downey pushing through middle. And he gets a lot of damage into Rez, but still 2 hit points left on him. Eventually, will finish it and takes down Draken, so good news there is it's only Zelos. Make it towards B, 1v4. And there's some players to deal with towards Checkered. He does take the fight versus Dominate, but won't win it. So we'll see the follow-up round go to the CT side. So back and forth, again we go. I wonder when a team is going to be able to string 2 in a row. I am uncertain as we continue to go back and forth. Another buy underway.
Still struggling.
Oh no. It's got a potato PC. Excuse, laser.
Carry on.
We'll see. Epsilon here with only a Tech 9 on Disco Doppler. Everybody else fairly equipped. So we should have a decent chance here. Freddy and Draken taking some damage early towards B, but spread out approach here. Not committing to anything early. Got Rez looking towards A main. Doppler holding the squeaky push here. And they're hoping that Archangel will get aggressive considering what they've seen thus far, but doesn't look like it's going to be the case. Draken, first battle here in the midst of a smoke. That was awkward. Downey somehow comes out on top. I guess, to be fair, he was at the advantage. The other player was inside of the smoke. He was not, but he couldn't really see him, so will be a 5-on-4 as the T's still haven't decided on anything just yet.
Yeah, not just yet. I mean, decent damage onto Downey, but I guess I want to stick one guy at the A side. That's Rez. Everybody else staying very silent towards B. Freddy B has been constantly peering into the checkers area. So I think they're going to go with Rez. Try to cause a rotate. That third man has been drawn over, though, so it will be a 3-on-2 whenever Epsilon do execute into the B-bomb site, but they're waiting for the success of failure of Rez. Never mind, time to go. Double members inside of the bomb site for Archangel. Dominate left. He's really been struggling this match, and they'll give up the B-bomb site. Rez, job well done.
So 3-on-3, retake scenario. And Freddy finds the first swift headshot towards heaven. Through the wall as well, Disco Doppler right underneath the vents, able to take down the first. Little did he recognize there was a second one on his way, so Zendi finds himself a 1v2. Cheeky smoke from Zelos, as that causes some problems for Zendi as he moves up into the bomb site. Freddy up in heaven, it should be an easy frag for him. And indeed it is, as he peeks out of heaven, so.
Are they gonna do it, Chad? The math is right.
Do we keep going here? I sure hope so. Gotta keep this ride going.
The math is right. I mean, you got 3 kills. You know your opponent didn't have an economy. You're looking at... Ooh, they're not looking at a double save, though, upon... So they're not going to go for the 4 spy. We're not going to get our wish. We're not going to get the 8-9. I'm still waiting on the full half. 4 spy back and forth. It's got to happen sometime, right. But I suppose it already would have. But only a single save here. Dominate. Left wanting next round as well as Rez. Both entry frags as he goes into the squeaky area. Still 2 members of Archangel at the A bomb site. And I don't think it would have the same impact as say like on Inferno where You send two members down banana on CT, keep members in the bomb site, and hope they run into your stack. That doesn't work necessarily the same way as a bomb site. Chad, when are we gonna stop referencing Inferno?
Right.
I suppose people still do it.
There's so many like fundamental plays and strats that
were
just derived from Inferno.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So I feel like it's gonna be. To be fair, like look at how we talked about Nuke for the longest time when it was no longer like. Maybe it was just me talking about like third maps and knife rounds, and that was the only talk of it. But at least I was still talking about it. So anyhow, I imagine Inferno is gonna be very similar. Although it is gone, it is still in our hearts.
No, it's gone.
Maybe
stricken
not.
From mine. I hated that map for eternity. That map and Nuke. Well, Nuke's back, so I guess I can't have everything. Aggression coming out from Archangel towards the Squeaky, and they know exactly what's going on. Epsilon have to get a move on it, and soon, because the full rotation is on its way. Archangel still a bit concerned that it may be a player lurking near the CT for Epsilon, but a five-man execute. They're trying to run the headshot lane. They have dealt with the player inside of the bomb site. Zendi, oh, quicks. He rushes through the smoke, donates a frag over to Epsilon. 3-on-3. I think I favor the CTs here.
See Draken go down.
Wow.
Now a 2-on-2. Disco Doppler looking strong here. Takes down Downy. It's now Zendi in a 1v2. He's going to make his way through the smoke, but that will be the end of him as he doesn't want to wait for it to dissipate. And yeah, interesting decision there. I think, as you mentioned, Quicks just YOLOing through the smoke. Doesn't work out well. And I was going to be a little critical. I think it was Freddy that decided to just run straight up that mid ramp. A lot of teams will decide to do that when they don't have any coverage towards heaven, and that is just the most open angle in the world towards heaven, and he was not even looking that direction, so need to be very weary of that. But well, they take the round, so can't say too much about it. 3 in a row for Epsilon, as we're gonna see a save fighting for overtime here. This is the CT side.
So the past eco was an A stack. Epsilon predict it's not going to be another one, or they're just confident in their ability to run right through a potential stack. It will be the fastest of possible rotates, though. Is everybody going to try to storm up the highway? Problem is, Epsilon already put down some fire, and Zellos just turns his back. That's definitely not a smoke, my friend. Oh, God, I got to get a screenshot of where this guy died. He's on top of the railing. He's hanging by his foot, Chad.
Oh, that's always a good one. Ragdoll effect, where they're just hanging off of something.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Beautiful indeed. Check out Laser Jesus Twitter if you want to check out that screenshot. There you go. Anyhow, moving forward, 15 rounds for Epsilon. And again, the CT is saving for basically to put up a hold to force the overtime situation. 8 rounds. It's a lot to come back from. I feel like it's just enough that you can make that debate that it's a better idea to go for maybe the overtime rather than force buying the last round. But, we'll see if they can get it done here as number of rounds in a row required. Epsilon have built up a bit of an economy, nothing too crazy. They're very spread out at the moment, recognizing that there might be some shenanigans from the streets of chaos, but early damage dealt to Rez, and he actually falls via the door spam and an HE grenade placed in his location. So early start here for the CT side, 4-on-5. Look at this aggression too. Quicks is just running through Squeaky. Okay, that's one way of going about it. He's like, we killed a guy there. Must be clear. He just sprints towards the back side of it, the T side of it, and takes down a player. So, well, that's cool.
Quicks is active, and he goes for the re-peek. Chad, he's lost his mind. He's the player that was having mouse issues the whole time. We saw in that 3-on-3 retake round where he just decides to rush through the smoke, not in tandem with his teammate. And I suppose one thing it has done. Oh, Zealous turns around. He was going towards the Squeaky area. You don't expect another player to be at that Squeaky area. Zealous still might suffer the same fate, though. He's gotta start walking. Well, at least get his smoke away. All right. Oh, poor guy. Couldn't even get the smoke right, Chad.
He botches a smoke, launches a flash, jumps forward, and dies, just as bad as it gets. Luckily, Draken has made his way behind the enemy lines, so maybe he can find something here. Zendi is trying to keep control of this bomb, and even if he finds the frag quickly, don't think there would be very much time to get that bomb down, so Draken falls, and we'll see the 9th round pulled in for the CT side. What a bizarre one.
Yeah, that was... We had Quicks with the double aggression into Squeaky, even with 20 HP. Then we had Zelos with the highlight play of the match, or Blazing Buffalo play of the match. We already explained it. It was hilarious. Hopefully we got it on stream. But 9 rounds now for Archangel. Still need 6 just to tie, and that's always... it's always on the mind. You want to forget about it, and you want to take it round by round, but it's always there that we're still just playing for the tie. It gets a little bit easier as the gap gets closed. Quick's hitting us. Another frag, though, as Rez trying to trade off for his teammate, catching them falling back off the highway. But this can happen when you're going for the spread out approach with the mid aggression. You want to trade off for your teammate, but instead you get killed, and then 3-on-5, and T's don't come back from a lot of 3-on-5 situations.
Now, as he dominate, he's going to be flushed out. Makes it through the fire. And Zelos can't punish him for it. Tries to dive through smoke, and he does fall. So, thought maybe they would create a situation they could come back from with that Molotov play. So, they knew dominate was deep in that back corner of Checkered. So, was able to flush him out with a Molotov. Disco Doppler now 1v4. He does have 2 flashes, but not going to make his position known just yet here, as he's slowly clearing angles in this B-bomb site, and now he would be the first one to fall. Lots of damage dealt in the process, so Disco Doppler flashes his way in. White
checks
dominate. Excellent work from Disco Doppler. This is a winnable round in my eyes. Fetched is very low.
How did he know? Disco Doppler, no wizard. Gonna put the Molotov down for headshot, and then take a new position at the triples in the back of the site. He wants to take the headshot fight with the player. Oh no, I think that Molotov's gonna get him anyways. Should have extended. 5 is possible, but I just don't see it. Epsilon, I think they're gonna win one of these last 5. They have to, unless they get too cozy and too comfortable and go for some crazy plays. Which they do have the propensity to do so, but 5. They only need 1. Let's check the loss bonus. Currently at 2. They're going to have a couple of gun rounds.
Yeah, buying into this one will be not a fantastic buy. Tech-9's on the field. We got Draken with an AK. But to be fair, Tech-9's are pretty good. We've seen that displayed in this map thus far. So we'll see if this is actually going to be the round where they make it happen. Draken actually fully bought when the rest of the team didn't. Interesting decision there, that comfortable play style, like you were stating, maybe taking effect. We'll see if it bites them in the end here, as we're seeing A smokes. There's Draken and Freddy are waiting towards B. Maybe they're hoping for the CTs to get aggressive and rotate. It looks like a mid-boost underway. Downey is able to find both. So no trade in effect, and it will have to be a B-side play.
No other options, really. Dominate gets flanked. Freddy B with that Tech-9. He just rips apart site solo. Did it at the A-bomb site, showing us he could do it at B as well. And now the AK is going to come into play of Draken. It was a brilliant play by Downey. The round where Epsilon tried to throw their A-fake to B, Downey was pushed up under the boost, and he heard everything going on. But Freddy B with the fallen weapon, his teammate putting in some work as well. How do you lose this round if you are the Archangels? Maybe they won't go. Downey onto Freddy. Quicks follows it up. And now just Zelos. Tech-9s have been deadly. Not for Zelos, though. Still, a lot of work put in that round. And enough to cut into the bye of the round following for Archangel. That round should not have happened the way it did at all because of the Downey play. I gotta highlight it again. The round Downey pushes up. And below the boost is the round Epsilon try to sell their fake. With him there, it's all the intel in the world. Freddy doesn't get that kill. It should be a clean round.
Yeah, again, Dominate, I imagine that he did not see them cross, because the way he was playing out that safe box, he was not aiming at that headshot area at all. He was just hiding, essentially. So he's blindsided by the Tech-9, and that was the B-bomb site, essentially. So we'll see if Dominate fine-tunes things a little bit here, as Draken very forward just rushes towards B. And, well, Quick's gonna follow
up. What's going on, Chad?
I have no idea. This is a bizarre start of the round. Disco Doppler fires back and finds 1. So silver lining there, but 4-on-3.
It's like the 15th round is just blinded Epsilon or something. That was... I can't tell what the strat was, what the intention was at the beginning, and... It seems like they're getting a little cozy for the Epsilon side, like already thinking they have the W. And another thing to highlight is what they've been buying into these rounds. Like, they have 5 rounds to play with, and their buying tendencies show me that they don't want to save for a full buy, or they'll just buy until they get to that point with a bomb plant. But the way it's going down recently, Archangels, we could still see overtime.
Epsilon might have a chance on the same bomb site as well. It comes down to how Zendi plays it. Quick's making his way up from highway as well to support. So now there is 2 around. Now it's only Quick's. And he's been having a rough time. He falls. So this could be the round right here. 3-on-2. Downy and Dominate on the retake.
And here they come. Disco. Been so impactful this time. He's completed his 30 bomb with that last kill. Now watch out for that fire, though. It does char him up just a bit. Only 3. But in comes the retake. Dominate to fall to Disco. That's his 31st. Make it 32. No, Downy puts him away. Has a very little bit of HP, but so do the remaining members of Epsilon. Should get the burn onto Res. 1 HP! And he peeks out from quad and brings down Downy. How did that only do 2 damage, Chad?
Right. He just hops away and, like, his shoelace caught on fire, but that's pretty much it. Interesting stuff, and that's gonna be the map right there. Map and match, rather. 2-0 Epsilon. Maybe a bit of a struggle there to close out Cash. Very dominant first map in Overpass. But in the end, it will be a 2-0. So they will move forward, and they make it into our playoff bracket for our close qualifier. Escape Gaming is now waiting for Archangels inside of our lower bracket finals for Group A. So that's not scheduled, but I believe that's one of the last matches we have for our group stage period. So I'm uncertain as to when our next match is going to be. It might be tomorrow, but it might not. So best way to find out is to follow us on Twitter at GoRGNTV. And you can follow me at Sprawl, just 2 L's on the end there, and at Laser Jesus for my good buddy here. So hope you guys enjoyed. That was an exciting one. Even though it was a 2-0 victory, I still thought it was good. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed as well. So we'll see you next time. Have a great evening, afternoon, whatever time it is. We'll see you next time.